Bad country for life here. So I'm gonna share with you what I pack. Let's give it some light here. What I pack in my tool kit. And I know a lot of people use a tool roll, but what I have found to work is one of these kind of hardy bags. This is a tough built bag that I picked up at Cal Ranch. And they're very durable. And I like them because I can also, you know, kind of squeeze them into a roll if I need to and put them inside one of my pannier bags if I am packing. It also fits into my tank bag, which is nice. So how about I just dump it all out here and show you what I got, what I take. I know this is a mess. It's definitely a mess. It's not convenient like a tool, but I found that the tool rolls, just all the fabric adds more bulk. Sure, it doesn't add weight, but it just adds more bulk. When you're rolling it all up, it starts to get fat and with all these components. So I ride a 2018 Triumph Tiger 800 XCA. And so what I've done is I've actually used each one of these on my bike, which I recommend everyone do when they get a bike. Some tips that I got from some friends. When I first started adventure riding a few years ago, I kind of just purchased a bunch of tools. And unfortunately, my tool roll was very large. And so it ended up just taking too much space. So now what I've done is I've minimized it a little bit into this mess. You know, I'm not really diving into my tool roll that often. Into my tools when I ride, fortunately. So I don't mind it being thrown into a bag like this, which is a recommendation I got from a friend. And I have seemed to like it ever since I converted to a bag instead of a roll, but to each their own. So what I've got in here is I obviously got some zip ties, and I also have some longer zip ties that are not in this bag that I put into one of my side pannier bags, but I like to carry the metal ones because they're very strong, and I have some really long ones. I think I have some 18 inch, maybe some 24 inch ones that I carry in my bag, but just an assortment of zip ties, which have come in handy quite a bit. Also, you know, I haven't had to use these though, but these clamps could come in handy if the zip ties don't work and you need something maybe a little bit stronger. You can pick these up at Harbor Freight for cheap, and do not get zip ties at Harbor Freight. That's my recommendation. You know, get some quality zip ties. These clamps are okay. They work good. A backup. I don't use this as my everyday air gauge, but this is a backup. I also have a adjustable wrench here. This is an 8-inch, 200 millimeter. This is from Harbor Freight, so it's light, but it also can tackle most of the big jobs. A steel stick, epoxy putty, emergencies. And then I got an assortment of actual wrenches. This is a combo wrench that has a 12 and a 10 on the other end. Kind of a specialty wrench there. Harbor Freight with some duct tape. We got a 14, got a 27. I like to use this just because it is a hex. And so it's a closed end wrench, which you would think maybe, okay, I could use this to remove my tire. You know, let's use one of these open wrenches and I can, you know, maybe toss this, but I don't recommend that. You definitely want to have a closed end wrench that's the right size for your bolt. Just because this could strip your bolt a lot easier than closed end. So my recommendation is to get the right size for your wheels to take those wheels off. Also have a T-handle that slides. This one is a 3/8 that goes to a 1/4 inch, and I also have some other, another adapter, I think somewhere around here, here it is. This one is 3/8 that goes to a 1/2 for some larger jobs, which I need for my front wheel. I have to have a 17 inch hex to get my front wheel off. So unfortunately, I can't leave without this. So I need to have that. That's a 1/2 inch, which goes in there. And then I can actually just connect that to here. And there we go. And that's all said and done. So sliding T-handle is great because you can use it for multiple jobs. Recommend that for sure. And then along with this is assortment of Torx and hex bits that I can use because I have, oh, actually my adapter is on my bike. So I have a bit adapter that can attach to my 1/4 inch drive here. And then I can use any bit that I need to. Locking pliers, you know, I take these as a backup just in case. I think they would be good if you need to close a hose. You could also use a zip tie for that if you need to, but to close, to clamp a hose or maybe to hold something while you're trying to break free a bolt. You never know. It's just maybe a nice to have. So that's kind of a backup. Adds a little bit of weight, but that's the backup there. This is a really cheap, just adjustable ratchet bit holder. So, you know, if I need to quickly do something on the bike and get into a tight space, I love how this ratchet is small, compact, and you could also ratchet it, which is nice. So I bring that, really cheap at Harbor Freight. Some other wrenches here, even a 8mm. Also, I have an extension 1/4 inch drive. I got 2 of them, one small and one long. If I really need to get in there, I can make this very long if I have to. And then I have a bit adapter, magnetic, some actual sockets, all metric for my bike. These are all 1/4 inch drives. And you don't need to carry every socket, but you definitely want to carry the main size sockets. If you have to get into your bike, that will be a plus. Something that you wouldn't be able to get in with a wrench because it's in there. Something that you could easily do through an extension to get into your bike. So that's one option there for you. I got a small assortment of some miscellaneous bolts and nuts that go in my bike if I lose them. And some washers. I have Threadlock Blue. You probably don't want the red because then your bolt will never come off. This is for my chain. It's just a backup thing, a link, a master link, in case I have an issue with my chain. Some wire, a hex Allen, or an Allen, you know, little wrench there. This is just a Velcro, a couple of Velcro things, light. They don't take up much room. Got a spark plug socket, and just some miscellaneous small items for electrical issues, you know, maybe you need to combine a wire, something like that. You know, it doesn't add much space, obviously, and they're super light, so it doesn't really add weight to enough to be concerned about. So this is kind of what I pack inside my tool roll, and so far on my last trip, it worked out really well. I had to take apart some of my plastics, just plastics on the side, and the tank, had to remove the tank, and I didn't have this with me. Unfortunately, this would have been really handy to get into some of those tight spaces around the handlebars and the forks, and so I'm gonna bring this for sure next time. But came in handy, was able to use my Allens, my bits, and so just, you know, check out your bike, make sure, got my light on here, so I'm probably blinding you all. make sure that you test all of the tools on your bike so that you know that you actually need them. You don't want to be bringing any tools that don't work on your bike, because then you're just carrying unnecessary weight. So I hope you enjoyed this video, just to give you a little bit of insight into some of the tools that I carry. But please like and subscribe if you like this content, and you know, check out some of my other videos I have on just some of the rides that I've been on. But thanks for tuning in to my channel and checking out what I got. Hope this helps you on your next adventure, your next ride, and packing some of the stuff that you need to pack for your bike. So with that, take care, safe travels.